Hello children, now today we are going to start a new chapter, that is sexual reproduction in animals. So in a previous video we have studied about the sexual reproduction in plants. Now in this topic we will talk about the sexual reproduction, okay, and then we will talk about the different cells which are involved in the sexual reproduction, okay, and then events involved in sexual reproduction, and then we will study about the viviparous and the oviparous animals. So children, this is your chapter, reproduction in animals. So here animals, this reproduction is the basic characteristic of the living organism. In the previous video also I have talked about the plants. Plants, as they are considered as a living organism, so there the fruit, seed and the flowers were there to reproduce the new plant. So similarly in animals, they produce the young ones, okay, of their own kind, and these young ones are known as the offsprings. So here also the sexual reproduction and asexual reproductions are there, okay, and the smaller organisms, they are having the smaller animals, just like amoeba and the paramecium, they are having the binary fission and the multiple fission. Now children, when we talk about the sexual reproduction, as I have told you before also, that two parents of male and the female are needed, okay, whereas in asexual, that was only the single parent was able to do the reproduction and to produce a new one, okay. But here you see two parents are involved and each will give their sex cells, and these sex cells are known as the gametes, okay, the sex cells are known as the gametes. So when we talk about the female gamete, they will produce the eggs, okay, and when we talk about the male gamete, that is the sperm, okay. So male gamete and female gamete, when they fuse together, then they form the zygote, and then further the development take place, and then the result will be the new individual. Children, here you can see the sperm cell or the male gamete also. This is the structure, okay, this is the head region, and then this is the nucleus, and this one is the tail region, okay, this is the centriole and the mitochondria. So these are the simple structure. In detail we will study in 9th standard. Now here you can see the sexual reproduction. They are having the female will give the egg or the ovum. We are talking about the human beings here, 23 chromosomes, and the sperms, they are also having the 23 chromosomes. Now when the fertilization takes place, that there will be the fusion of these two gametes, male gamete and the female gametes, and then they will form the zygote, and the zygote will further develop into the embryo. Now children, next is the events involved in sexual reproduction. See, in this chapter you will go through only for the introductory part, okay, and in detail you will study in the higher classes. So here the introductory part is what events which are involved in sexual reproduction. It's a step-by-step process. So first is the formation of gametes. So this formation of gametes, that is called the gametogenesis. It happens when the animal gets mature, okay, when they will reach to the maturity, then only this gametes will start producing into the individual's body, okay. So that stage is called the formation of gametes. Without the gametes, the individual will be unable to do the sexual reproduction. Now the next step is the fertilization, that is the fusion of male and female gametes. Okay, so once the gametes will be formed, then only the fertilization will take place. Either it will be given directly or it will be given indirectly, in both cases. Okay, the fertilization is also of two kinds, external and internal fertilization. Then that we will study in the next topic. Okay, now the next one is the development of embryo. Once the fertilization will be completed, then the embryo will be formed, okay, the embryo will be formed, and this process is called the embryogenesis, Okay, now once the embryo will be formed, then it will start developing into the new individual, and that process is called the development. So children, here there are four steps: gametogenesis, fertilization, embryogenesis, and the development. Children, as I have told you about the gametogenesis, that it is produced when the male and female get matured. So this is the reproductive cells, and they are formed in the reproductive organs of the males and the females, and they are formed by the type of cell division. This cell division is called the reduction division. So only the sex cells are formed because of this kind of cell division, that is called the reduction division. Now the next topic is fertilization. So as I have told you before also, the process of fusion of sperm nucleus with the nucleus of the ovum or the egg is called the fertilization. So earlier you have studied about that fusion of male gamete and female gamete. Okay, now here the specific thing is told: sperm nucleus with the nucleus of the ovum or the egg. Okay, so here we are considering the nucleus of the sperm and nucleus of the ovum, and when a sperm and the ovum fuses together, then they form the zygote. Okay, so this is called the fertilization. Okay, and this is the first cell of the new organism. So starting is the zygote of any new individual. Now this fertilization is of two types: external fertilization and internal fertilization. External fertilization, as I told you, that the externally these fusion will take place. Okay, the fusion of sperm nucleus and the fusion of with the nucleus of the ovum, that is external body, outside the body, just like in it happens in the aquatic animals. So frog, they will release their sperm into the water, and then their fusion will take place. Similarly in fishes also. Internal fertilization, that is the fusion of male and female gamete take place inside the body of the female. So directly this one will be fused inside the female body. Okay, the male gamete will be directly given to the female body. Okay, so this is the internal fertilization. Again, you can see children, in a short way, eggs fertilize outside the female body, that is the external fertilization. That's why it is called the fertilization which takes place outside the body, that is called the external fertilization. So eggs fertilize outside the female body, and it occurs mostly into the aquatic environment. Okay, that is a fish and the amphibians. Now what are the drawbacks of this external fertilization? First is the many eggs and sperms are produced, so some survive. Okay, that means plenty of eggs and sperms are released inside, and it's not necessary that all will fertilize, okay, or fuse. And the eggs and the sperm may not meet, they may be eaten, or there will be the environmental or conditions may change. Okay, environmental conditions may change. That means sometimes the environmental conditions are not favorable, then what will happen? The fusion will not take place. Okay, now children, if we talk about the internal fertilization, that is the it is an important adaptation of life on land. That means the land animals, they are able to do the internal fertilization because they don't have any medium. Okay, and fertilization occurs inside the female's body, and the copulation, that is male deposits sperm directly into the female's reproductive tract. Now what is the significance of fertilization, or you can say the importance of fertilization? Because of this fertilization, what happens, the new individual, whatever is formed, they will carry the characteristic of both parents, male and female characteristics. Okay, that means you see that the parents are having some sort of characteristic which will resemble to the child's characteristic, just like the hair color of the father and the son are same, or father or the daughter are same. Okay, so that is the they are inheriting the characteristic from one generation to the another generation. Sometimes it resembles the mother in certain characters and the father in some other characters. Okay, just like height, you are similar with your mother's height. Okay, so it is what? You are carrying the height characteristic from your mother to you. Okay, so that's why children of same parents not only resemble their parents but also each other. In your book, a picture is given here, that is the process of fertilization, how the fertilization takes place into the animals. See, this is the egg cell, and as you know, the male will release its sperm into the female body. So these sperms will get surrounded, they will surround the egg. Okay, but only the strongest one may enter inside the egg. Okay, so and the rest one will be, you can say they will be destroyed by itself because they are having the certain lifespan. Now next is the development of the embryo, that is embryogenesis, and then it will be further, the next step will be the development. So the zygote divides repeatedly. They will start dividing themselves cell to cell, cell to cell, and then its cells form different tissues and organs, and this developing structure is called the embryo. The embryo then develops into the young one or the baby, and the development may occur outside or inside the body of the female. The development, that means slowly and gradually, when they are born, they are of different structure, and slowly and gradually they will develop some other structure, and then they will become a full individual, which are similar to their parent. Now children, the next topic is viviparous and oviparous animals. Viviparous animals are those animals which are able to give birth to the babies, and also they feed their babies with their milk. So they are having the mammary gland. Okay, and the animals which lay eggs are known as the oviparous. Just like insects, fishes, frogs, birds, reptiles, etc. So if you want to know about the other differentiation, other characteristic through which you can easily understand that they are the viviparous one or the oviparous one, you can see the ears. Two kinds of ears are present in the living organism, either the internal ears or the external ears. The ears which are visible from outside, they are known as the external ears. So the animals which are having the external ears, they are able to give birth to the young ones, and they feed their young ones with the milk. Okay, whereas those who are having the internal ears, that means the ear is not visible from outside, just like fish, frog, birds, they lay eggs. Okay, so children, this is the very easy way to differentiate the oviparous and the viviparous on the basis of the external ears. So here you can see the external ears, they are having the viviparous cow and the dog, giraffe, monkey, donkey, cat, and the human being. So what they will do? They will give birth to the young ones, and they will feed their babies with their milk. And these all are having the internal ears, and they are able to give eggs, and you can see they lay their eggs, and then they give birth to the new individuals when the egg hatch, and then the new individual comes out from the egg. So this was all about this chapter. Rest things are not in your course. Okay, so students, hope you all have understood the topics. If you have any doubt or question, you can ask in the comment section below. Please like, share it with your classmates, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get my latest updates. Thank you and take care.